the true story of the Frenchman who would eat anything. Tarrare was a young Frenchman from the 1700s, and he would literally eat anything. Born with a kind of metabolic disorder that was never diagnosed, he simply couldn't get full, and in order to abate this raging appetite, Tarrare would eat everything, literally everything, in sight, from inanimate objects to even live animals. Born somewhere near Lyon in 1772, by the time he became a teenager, Tarrare only weighed a measly 100 pounds, despite the fact that he ate enough meat to equal a quarter of a cow every day. He was described as having abnormally wide jaws, with some reports saying he could easily hold 12 eggs in his mouth at a time. His skin would hang so loosely that he could wrap the folds of skin from his abdomen around his waist. When full, his abdomen would distend like a huge balloon. Unfortunately, Tarrare was eating so much that his parents kicked him out of the house at the age of 17 because they just couldn't afford to continue feeding him. He was forced to live on the streets, traveling through France with a band of thieves and prostitutes, begging for and stealing food, before becoming the warm-up act to a traveling charlatan. His act consisted of eating whatever the audience threw at him, including corks, stones, an entire basket of apples, even live cats. Apparently, he was particularly fond of snake meat. It was said that Tarrare's body was hot to the touch and he sweated heavily. He constantly had horrible body odor that was described as stinking, quote, to such a degree that he could not be endured within the distance of 20 paces. This smell would get noticeably worse after he had eaten. His eyes and cheeks would become bloodshot. He had chronic diarrhea, which was said to be fetid beyond all conception. Despite his large intake of food, Tarrare did not appear to gain any weight. In 1788, Tarrare moved to Paris to work as a street performer. He appears to have been successful in general, but on one occasion the act went wrong and he suffered severe intestinal obstruction. Members of the crowd carried him to the Hotel Dieu hospital where he was treated with powerful laxatives. He made a full recovery and offered to demonstrate his act by eating his surgeon's watch and chain. The surgeon was unimpressed by the offer and warned him that if he did so, he would cut Tarrare open to recover the items. In 1792, Tarrare enlisted in the French Revolutionary Army to fight the War of the First Coalition. Since food was scarce and often severely rationed, he would eat any available food from gutters and from trash heaps, but his condition still deteriorated through hunger. In the army, Tarrare was hospitalized due to exhaustion and became the subject of a series of medical experiments to test his eating capacity, in which, among other things, he ate a meal intended for 15 people in a single sitting, ate lizards and puppies, and swallowed eels whole without chewing. At this time, General Alexandre de Beauharnais decided to put Tarrare's extraordinary eating skills to military use and employed him to be a courier for the French army, with the intention that he would swallow documents, pass them through enemy lines, and recover them from his stool once safely at his destination. The only problem with that plan was that Tarrare could not speak German and on his first mission was captured by the Prussian forces, severely beaten, and even underwent a mock execution before being returned to the French. Scarred from the experience, Tarrare agreed to submit to any procedure that might cure his appetite and was treated with laudanum, tobacco pills, wine vinegar, and soft-boiled eggs. The procedures failed and doctors could not keep him on a controlled diet. He would sneak out of the hospital to scavenging gutters, rubbish heaps, and outside butcher shops, attempted to drink the blood of other patients in the hospital, and tried to eat the corpses in the hospital morgue. After being suspected of eating a toddler, he was ejected from the hospital. 4 years later, in 1798, Tarrare was admitted to the Versailles Hospital. Tarrare, now bedridden and weak, had told hospital doctors they had swallowed a golden fork 2 years earlier, which he believed was lodged inside him and caused his current weakness. Doctors, however, recognized that he was actually suffering from advanced tuberculosis. A month later, Tarrare began to experience explosive continuous diarrhea, dying shortly afterwards. With his corpse rotting quickly, an autopsy was done on Tarrare's body, where it was discovered that his liver and gallbladder were the size of coconuts. His stomach, which was covered in ulcers, took up almost the entire space of his torso, and that almost his entire body was filled with pus. To this day, the cause of Tarrare's behavior is still not known. While there are other documented cases of similar behavior from this period of time, none of the subjects other than Tarrare were autopsied, and there have been no modern documented cases resembling Tarrare. Some speculate that it was hyperthyroidism, others say he suffered from extreme thyroid disease, still others say that Tarrare may have suffered from brain damage. So the next time you say, "I'm so hungry I could eat a horse," just know that there was once a man in this world that probably actually tried it.